Hello and welcome to a series of four videos to move away from R404A. First video is the regulation frame and alternative candidates. Second is the alternatives to R404A and R134A. Third is impact on system performance, and fourth would be component selection and tools. My name is John Broughton. I work for Danfoss Cooling as a global application expert. Now, when we look at a replacement refrigerant, we basically have to go on a journey. We have to look at the application, so temperature range, the capacity range of the refrigeration system, and then look what's installed in the system, what type of compressor, what type of expansion valve, etc. Then we search out potential candidates. So we need to know if they have an impact on the refrigeration system performance. Do they increase performance or do they decrease performance? Could we use an A2L refrigerant, for example, or an A3? So the focus is on the refrigerant performance and the temperature range. Then we have to look at the component availability and suitability of the equipment that's available in the marketplace, but also the equipment that's installed on the system right now. Then we make a decision, do we do a drop-in? So do we exchange purely the refrigerant? Maybe we make an adjustment to the superheat setting on the expansion valve, or do we have to do a retrofit, which would mean replacing part of the refrigeration system, could be the expansion device, for example, or do we build a new system? Drop-in would be a short term, maybe medium term. Retrofit, again, short, medium. Long-term solution would be to build a new system that's maybe suitable for the new low GWP refrigerants, maybe natural refrigerant, for example. Let's come on to the Montreal Protocol. Now, this came into force 1st of January 2019. At least 20 countries ratified the protocol. And it has to be said that the EU phase down is not based exactly on the same measures as the Montreal Protocol, but uses, you know, roughly the same framework. Now, this first table shows the stepwise reductions for Article 5 countries and non-Article 5 countries. And basically, a non-Article 5 country is a developed country, and an Article 5 country is a developing country. And they're split depending which country we are talking about. But more importantly, let's come on to this graph showing the consumption phase down, again for Article 5 and non-Article 5 countries. And we have on the left-hand side, we have the percentage of baseline, and along the bottom, we have the year. Now you can see the red line, which is the EU F-gas regulation, has a much tighter phase down process. And if we think about this, the idea of the Montreal Protocol was to reduce the emission of greenhouse gases measured in CO2 equivalent, which is also known as global warming potential, or GWP. Now, as you can see there, from the 1st of January 2020, refrigerants with a GWP greater than or equal to 2,500 are not allowed to be used anymore in new systems. That means R404A and 507A are mainly affected. This slide shows the main alternative refrigerants in play. It is a picture of continuous change. Now, along the bottom, we have the density of the refrigerant, going from vacuum refrigerants, low, medium and high density. And at the bottom right hand side, we have other, which is CO2 and ammonia. And then up the side of the chart, we have the GWP, the global warming potential, very low at the bottom, very high at the top. And you can see R404A up there at the top, around about the 2500 mark. In the middle of the slide, we have the flammability line, which means any refrigerant above the flammability line is non-flammable, and any refrigerant below the flammability line is flammable, whether it's mildly flammable or flammable. Now, depending on the type of system we're talking about and the compressor technology, that would depend whether we use a vacuum refrigerant. They're generally used in centrifugal machines, things like air conditioning chillers. And then we come up to the low, medium and high density refrigerants. generally using the same technology type of compressors, but each has their own benefit, let's say. Now, this slide shows the refrigerant solutions from a Danfoss viewpoint, that has to be said, and this is how we see the short-term and long-term development of refrigerants based on those applications. So at the top, we've got the centralized system, the supermarkets, in the middle, the condenser units, and then down the bottom, the self-contained units. Now, one of the challenges, I guess, with this is that we do expect to see an increase in use of natural refrigerants wherever possible, because the natural refrigerants have a lower GWP. However, due to legal aspects, such as the flammability, we may still see, even long-term, some synthetic refrigerants in use. Thank you. That is the end of the first video.